My mother made up stories about Wiggly Wiggly the snail and Herbert the caterpillar and read to me from the Oxford nursery. By the time I was 5 or 6, my head was crammed with riddles and tongue twisters, skipping songs and counting songs, ballads, carols, and half-remembered lullabies. They entered me as easily as people, till I hardly knew when I was thinking my own thoughts and when I was writing them. Soon after I was 8, my parents moved to Scotland and I was sent to weekly boarding school. I hated it. School was an agony with its forced gregariousness, days sliced apart by bells. In a world where home had been reduced to half a dresser top, just enough room for a framed photograph of your parents and a plastic statue of the Virgin Mary, books were the only luxury that remained. I carried one in my satchel at all times, so I could snatch a few paragraphs between lessons. I didn't read in church or during meals, but I read in the car on the way home from school, I read on the john and the bath, I read perched on the fireboard in the nursery and underneath the bedroom through a flashlight. There was a window seat behind the curtains of my bedroom, and I used to crouch there in the dark, reading by moonlight, making out one small word at a time. Ordinary life was bumpy and tumultuous, full of questions and admonitions, of darling, please, and silence, girls, and who can remember the names of the Scottish coalfields? Books were a blessed antidote to all of that, joy and consolation and escape. I infinitely preferred them to real life. Why should I care if the other girls disliked me, if I couldn't turn proper cartwheels or make sense of French or Latin or geometry? My friends were Sarah Crewe and Pippi Longstocking. I was hiding under the floorboards with Arietti, watching Tom Sawyer as he managed not to paint that fence, or slipping down the bright stream with Dodder and Baldwin, Valdurin and Sleaze, the last rose in all.